Oh, that's fun. Oh, should I take one more? Yeah, go right ahead, ma'am.
Are cowboy poets
self-taught, or did I go to Iowa? Those are the two choices. Either you taught yourself or you went to Iowa. There ain't no other way. Cowboy poets are self-taught, and I'm glad you brought up my poetry because I'd like to read you a poem, folks. You guys want to hear a new poem? This is exciting. This poem has never been read anywhere before. This is the debut of this poem, and it's already being talked about for the Nobel Prize of the West, which is more prestigious than the regular Nobel Prize. Very different. So we were talking a moment ago about my most famous poem. You can bring the house lights down. I'm done looking at these people. My most famous poem, That Lonesome Cowboy, right? About fucking a hole in the ground. This poem picks up where that one leaves off. This poem is called There's Other Things a Cowboy Can Also Fuck. A lonesome cowboy out on the range will fuck things a city slicker might find strange. I am not speaking of the horse or the cow because fucking them isn't so strange anyhow. In the natural relationship between men and those beasts, there will always be a fucking once in a while, at least. So I, my friends, am not talking of that, nor am I talking about fucking your hat. There's nothing strange about cowboy hat fucking. This is not a topic any cowboy will try ducking. We all fuck our horses and our cows and our hats and our holsters and our boots and piles of coyote scat. I've told you before, we fuck holes in the ground in the poem, which is deservedly my most renowned. But there's other things a cowboy can also fuck. Some he has handy, others require some luck. It is no great matter to fuck a tree, a wallet, or a can of beans. Those things you can see. But a cowboy who's serious, determined, and disciplined, a cowboy like this can fuck the wind. It's got to have a speed of at least 40 miles an hour. And your hips have to have some serious thrusting power. But when conditions are right, she's a very tender lover. One of the best sex partners this cowboy has discovered. But don't do it too often. Don't get overzealous. Because if you fuck the wind too much, the earth will get jealous.
Thank you.
Yep. That's a poem about fucking the wind. I know sometimes the subtleties of language in poetry can be challenging, but just tell you that's what that's about. Now, a lot of you may be thinking, well, now he's told me you can fuck the earth and you can fuck the wind. Can a man fuck fire? The answer is, I don't think so. I have heard tell of an Indian shaman who they say could fuck a campfire. But I have also heard him described as a mentally ill person with a badly burned penis. So I would want more information before I tried it. That's my position. All right, folks. Well, that's just about all the time I have time for. But I want to make clear to all you folks, if any of you sons of bitches are monsters, that I keep a stake of wood on me at all times, and my six guns are loaded with silver bullets, and you are a therianthrope until proven otherwise. All right, folks, with that cheery thing out of the way.